Hello friends, this is Supriya Mughle. I am working as an assistant professor at Center for Distance Education, Shivaji University, Kolhapur. I am here to discuss about Introduction to Management Control System. So first we'll see introduction. There are three words in management control system: management, control and system. We'll see the meaning of each and every word. Management, as you know, as a management student, you know what is management. An organization consists of a group of people who work together to achieve certain common goals. It includes planning, organizing, directing, staffing, controlling, also cooperation, etc. comes under management. Then control. Control means measurement and controlling the process of gathering and feeding back information about the performance. So controlling is one of the important function of management. Here what you do, here the you have to measure the performance of the performance, everything for our sales or financial or HR working, they are working well or not, their performance etc. is measured, and you are going to compare your actual result with planned result. Are they matching? If not, if your result is not as per your standards, so what to do? You have to take some actions on that to reach to the standard result. So here you decide what to do about that problems. That is called control. And system. System, it is a prescribed and usually repetitive way of carrying out an activity of or a set of activities. Means there are activities in the business, various activities, and you are going to do it very systematically in repetitive way. Okay. So in organized way. So that is called system. So in detail, management control system is a logical integration of management tools to gather and report data and to evaluate the performance. So you are going to control. Control means measuring the performance. You are going to compare the actual with standard. That is controlling. And you are controlling the activities by having some innovative management tool, and it is going to have in repetitive way. That is called management control system. So a system which gathers and uses information to evaluate the performance of different organizational resources like human, physical resources, financial resources, etc. and organization as a whole, considering the organizational strategies. So a system which gathers, okay, for controlling it needs some data, right? So system is going to gather that data to evaluate the performance, and organizational resources you have to perform there also. For example, human, are they the employees who are working in the organization, are they working good or not? Physical resources means assets or machineries are used in the business, are they working good or not? Are they in need of maintenance, etc. Financial means as per our investment we are getting return or not, we are in the profit stage or not, or in what if we are in loss, what is wrong here. So all the department you are going to measure your performance, and you are going to compare the actual result with standard result, etc. comes under management control system. So in short, management control system is defined as a set of policies and procedures designed to keep operations going according to plan or not. That means as per your plan, everything is going right or not. So etc. comes under management control system. So there are boundaries of management control. First is strategic planning, then task control, and then management control. So what is strategic planning? Planning is, indicates itself. Planning means a process of deciding on the goals of organization and strategies of attaining these goals. That means you are going to have some planning, or you are going to decide some objectives that you have to attain. That objective that is called strategic planning. And then task control. Task control means process of assuring that specified tasks are given to the employees, or these are carried out effectively or efficiently, etc. is checked out in the task control. Means individual task is going to give to individual person, and you have to check that whether they are working or whether the tasks are carried out effectively or not, etc. comes under task control. And management control means process by which manager influence other members of the organization to implement the organizational strategy. That means first you are going to have the plan, you will decide objectives of your organization, of your business, and then individually you are going to give the task to the people, and then you are going to measure the performance, or you are going to implement these strategies by giving the task to the individual. So this is strategic planning, task control, and management control. They are interrelated. So you can see here, strategy formulation or strategy planning means goals and strategies and policies which are made, and then management control means implementing of these strategies, and task control means efficient and effective performance of individual tasks. So we will see in detail the difference between strategic planning, task control, and management control. Okay, so here I have explained some basis. On that basis we will have that difference. The first is, as a system, strategic planning is least systematic. Okay, it is a planning, it cannot have that in a repetitive way. Okay, the planning is done for one work only, and after completing that work you are going to have a new planning. So it should not be systematic way, it can change. Then task control, it is the most systematic, because individual tasks are given to everyone so that they can work efficiently and effectively. So it should be systematic way. And management control is lies in between means for some time it is least systematic, for some time it is most systematic, or it can be lies in between. Okay, so periodicity means what period. Then strategic planning is focuses on long run, like that means planning, you are going to have some strategies for your business, so that is for long run. And task control is for short run. Okay, for example, my strategy is to maximize the profit, it is long run planning. Okay, and task control means, for example, this month I have to I have that much target to increase the sale. For example, if suppose my business is having sale of 100 products per month, but in this month I am going to increase the sale by 50. So this is for short run, and management control is again lies in between. Accuracy. Accuracy in strategic planning, it is rough approximation of future. Obviously, it is a planning, means you are going to decide about future in advance. So it is rough approximation, it is not that much accurate. And in task control, you are going to use the current data. Okay, current data means of every department you are going to have that data. For example, HR, so what type of people are there, what are their skills, and what are our requirements, are they working very well or not, are they working as per standards, their performance, etc. is measured. So we will use that current data in task control. And management control again lies in between, means it will use the current data also, it will have that approximation also, and it will lies in between the both. Okay, rough and current exact data. So next is portion of planning and control. So strategic planning, in strategic planning, planning process is more important. Obviously, it is planning process, strategic planning. We are going to plan something. So planning process is more important here. And in the control process, task control process is more important. Controlling means you are going to measure the performance. Okay, and if it is not going in proper way, that means you are going to have that proper action on that activities. That is controlling. So in the task control, control process is more important. Then management control. Here planning and controlling both are equally important. Then nature of end product. What is your end product? End product in the strategic planning, obviously we will frame some objectives, we will frame goals, strategies and policies. This is our end product. Task control means here people are going to work as per the given tasks and they will come out with the efficient and effective performance. And in management control, whatever the strategies are formed or framed, etc., we are going to implement in the management control. So the next point is characteristics or features of management control system. So first is it focuses on programmers and responsibility center. Okay, responsibility center means it is a unit or subunit of an organization, usually headed by the managers, who become responsible and accountable for the activities or that unit of that or that subunit. Okay, then next is for the purpose of control, managers use two type of data, that is planned data and actual data. So here it is related with the estimation, budget and standard forecasting, etc., or detailing about the future events or activities. So the manager should have the planned data also and actual data also, where he will compare that data. Then the control process is a set of actions such as programming, budgeting, monitoring, evaluating and analyzing and reporting. So that means it is a continuous and ongoing process. Okay, so it should be done in repetitive way. It is continuous process. So in repetitive way, you are going to monitor, evaluate, analyze, etc. and reporting. Reporting means one person is going to report to the higher authority. So this will done in repetitive mode. Fourth is it is a total system covering all aspects of company's operation. So that means this is important because management functions assure that all the parts are balanced with one another. Unless management obtains information about each of them, coordination between all the activities is not possible. So it covers all the operations. Then fifth is it is a set of interlocking subsystem generating a single system. So the system is normally coordinated and integrated so that same set of information can be used by other units for some other purpose. So management control system is a set of interlocking the subsystems while designing reporting format. This aspect is carefully considered by the system manager. Then next is system is usually designed with financial figures and not with physical units of input and output. So management control system is designed with financial figures. Okay, because monetary unit is the only common denominator which can be used to express the heterogeneous inputs and resources such as kgs, pieces, liters or machine hours or labor hours, etc. So it is designed with financial figures. Then it reports are prepared and forwarded to the persons mentioned in the circulation list at regular intervals. So the system tends to be rhythmic, okay, not ad hoc. Means one time or occasional. It follows a regular timetable, like daily, weekly, fortnightly, or monthly, quarterly, half yearly, or annually. So year after year, you are going to have in repetitive time. So all reports are prepared on regular intervals. Then last is line and staff managers are equally involved in the control process. That means line managers are therefore they have focal points in the management control and they are equally involved in the control process. So these are some characteristics or features of management control system. Okay, so I hope you understood the concept. What is management control system? In the next video, we are going to learn in detail. So thank you so much.